Good afternoon, friends. In previous class, we have discussed the choice of rotor slots. So, the choice of rotor slots is also one of important factor and critical factor which affects on the performance of induction motor. Hence, in similar fashion, choice of stator slots and choice of rotor slots both are important. If any bad combination is selected, then motor behave unexpected performance. Okay. So point number one, we have to discuss the design of squirrel cage rotor. The squirrel cage rotor mainly consists a laminated core, because to reduce the heating effect or to reduce the eddy current loss, the core structure is laminated, and it also consists rotor bars and end rings. The rotor bars and end rings are made of aluminium or copper. The length of the rotor is the same that of the stator. So, in usual practice, in standard process, length of the rotor core must be equal to length of the stator core. That is, LR is the length of rotor core, L is the length of stator core, both are equal. But in some cases, some manufacturers will keep length of the rotor core as slightly higher than that of stator core in order to utilize the end fluxes effectively. Number one, then you observe cleanly diagram, the diameter of rotor is always slightly lesser than the stator diameter, that is stator core diameter, to avoid the mechanical friction between stator and rotor. So, it is separated by gap, that gap is known as length of air gap. So, whereas D naught is external diameter of stator core. So, the diameter of rotor, that is dr equal to d minus 2 times of lg, where lg is the length of air gap, d is the diameter of stator bore. All are in meters, you observe cleanly from diagram. Next, we have to see the estimation of rotor bar current. For three-phase induction motor, the rotor bar current is given by 6 times of ISDS divided by SR into KWS into power factor. The same equation is also written as in modified form, IB equal to 0.85 6 times of ISDS divided by SR, where IS is the stator current per phase, TS is the stator turns per phase, SR is total number of rotor slots. The performance of induction motor is greatly depends upon rotor resistance. Hence, the selection of rotor resistance is also one of important aspect. The higher rotor resistance has high starting torque. The higher rotor resistance, if we selected, it is for higher starting torque and less efficiency. The total resistance is sum of bar resistance as well as end ring resistance. The cross-sectional area of bars and end rings are selected to meet the requirements of starting torque and efficiency. The current efficiency in the rotor may be taken as 4 to 7 amperes per millimeter square. Hence, the area of rotor bar AB equal to respective bar current and respective current density. So, AB equal to IB divided by current density. It is in millimeter square. The rules for selection of rotor slots. The following general rules are used for choice of rotor slots. Number one, number of stator slots should not be equal to number of rotor slots. SS should not be equal to SR, first rule. And second, satisfactory results are obtained. This may be SS and SR, difference may be 15% to 30%. It should not be like that. Whether SS may be greater or SR may be greater, this selection both of slots should vary 15% to 30% of the values. Number two, the difference between SS minus SR should not be equal to plus or minus P, plus or minus 2P, plus or minus 3p to avoid the synchronous cusps, that is cogging effect in induction motor. The difference between SS minus SR should not be equal to plus or minus 3p for three phase induction motor to avoid the magnetic locking. Fourth one, the difference between SS minus SR should not be equal to plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, P plus or minus 1, P plus or minus 2 to avoid the noise and vibrations. Hence, to overcome all the effects, the rotor slots are used. Hence, it is very important in the selection of rotor slots, otherwise it will affect on the performance of motor. Summarizing all the above 4 points, the difference between SS minus SR should not be equal to 0, plus or minus P, plus or minus 2P, plus or minus 3P, plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus P plus or minus 1, plus or minus P plus or minus 2. Remember once again, selection of rotor slots mainly depends upon these rules. Thank you to one and all. Then what are the solutions, how these harmonic torques can be reduced? Hence, the following methods are used in India. Number one, chording. The chorded winding with integral number of slots per pole per phase will provide weakness of stator winding MMF harmonics. Chording means if we are using pull pitch winding, instead of pull pitch winding, we have to go for short pitch winding. For example, if pull pitch has 10 slots, instead of 10 slots, we can go for use of 9 slots. Hence, this is chorded by 1 slot. So, chording method is used. Number 2, integral slot winding. The windings with fractional number of stator slots per pole per phase creates a symmetrical MMF distribution in the air gap, hence which results more noise. To avoid this, we are going to use integral slot winding. Number 3, skewing. The motor noise, vibrations, cogging and synchronous cusps can be reduced by using skewing of rotor or skewing of stator. But in general commercial use, India, we are going to use the skewed arrangement of rotor bars in rotor core. Number 4, increase in the length of air gap. The increase in length of air gap also reduces the harmonics. Hence, it reduces the irregularity of length of air gap. Hence, but this increase in the LG is also affects all other performance of the motor. Thank you to one and all.